By now, you guys have probably seen the reveal trailer for Call of Duty Modern Warfare. If you haven't seen my breakdown of it, go watch that video after this one. But this video is a vlog where we got to go out to Infinity Ward and see Call of Duty Modern Warfare early. Get a ton of details about the game. And so I'm going to let you guys watch the vlog. And after the vlog, I'm going to come back and I'm going to share with you everything that I know about Call of Duty Modern Warfare. So I will see you guys in a few minutes. It's been a long time since I have turned on this camera to do a vlog for you guys. And this is a Call of Duty 2019 travel reveal vlog. It's always tricky to do these when you do them, but you can't put them up for a certain amount of time. So we are doing this in the past and it will go up in the future. I am about an hour away from heading over to Infinity Ward to get some form of reveal for Call of Duty 2019. Now, my guess, and most of you that watch the channel already know what my guess is. My guess and my bets are on Modern Warfare 4. We will see what happens. I do know, let me tell you what I know and what I don't know. What I don't know is what it's going to be. I don't know exactly what I'm going to see. I know I'm going to see something, and I know I'm going to be able to talk about it when this vlog goes up. And I know I'm going to be able to vlog certain things at Infinity Ward for you guys on this video right here. So I guess this is an intro to that. We'll cut away. When we come back, we will be at Infinity Ward with the other content creators that got invited out as well. Big shout out to Activision Infinity Ward for thinking about this washed up B-Squad Call of Duty YouTuber and extending the invite for me to be able to see this. I told you guys months ago, if this is what I think it's going to be, I'm all on board. I am a re-energized Call of Duty YouTuber, and you guys have already seen on the channel, the COD content is flowing. So let's go see what exactly Infinity Ward has been cooking up.
If there's a honey in the middle, there's a little leeway.
I just got her. It's the Sony one.
Hold on, Ryan. It's a slow zoom in case you wanted to know. Oh, this is great. Are you excited, Brad?
Yeah, you need to have it.
What is your prediction for what we're about to see?
My prediction is anime warfare. Your favorite anime characters battle it out in the dystopian future of Neo Tokyo.
Look how close I've got his face.
We're in the secret elevator going to the secret studio. It's not really a secret, but
you make sure you get all the best shots of shoulders.
It sounds good. It's been a while.
It's been a while.
It's been a minute.
Ghost 2? Ghost 2?
Ghost 2 confirmed.
Call of Duty Ghost 2. Marcel, you're not supposed to film in here.
Are we allowed to film? Sure.
We are. Do we need to sign again?
Right here.
Another one? This is the executive board meeting room. Yeah. Not really. All right, guys, we're in Infinity Ward's bunker. Everybody is filing in. What? It's just the logo.
All right, I'll do it too.
So apparently what's going to happen here is we're going to get to film our reactions. We're not going to get to film whatever they're going to show us, but we're going to be able to film everybody's reaction. Look at Pomaji's already smiling like a little kid. You can see behind us. So yeah, I think that's what's happening.
Always Ryan.
All right. Double filming here. Okay guys, I'm about to film my reaction to what I'm about to see on the screen for the Infinity Ward reveal.
Alright.
So I can't film the screen, and you really can't see anything that way. It's so dark. There it comes. There's like 50 people in there. You guys can hear it.
Good.
It feels like a horror movie right now.
The rules have changed.
Oh my god, that's brilliant.
War isn't black and white.
Oh my goodness.
It's gray.
Yes.
There's a fine line between right and wrong. And somewhere in the shadows. And send us in to find them.
Watch your 6 actual. Target is in the main house.
No.
Oh,
My man.
Bravo 6. Going dark.
Water.
Come on, hit us with it.
What?
What?
Come on,
just go.
Okay.
No, what a ship, right?
I called it. Yes.
That's what I wanted, dude.
I'm with this.
That's what I wanted.
Bro, I just speculated, man.
Yeah,
we got
it. But I can't say anything, right?
Like,
can't.
Oh my god. It's an
end
periscope.
So do we stop?
Is there more?
Yeah, bro.
We keep going?
Bang, baby.
The final frontier, just to fuck with people.
Can we turn our camera around now?
Camera's off.
I'm adding this in before I start the commentary, which is weird, I know, but I did want to let you know that cross-platform is confirmed. That's right, Xbox, PlayStation, PC, cross-platform play for Call of Duty for the first time ever, and there is no season pass. Okay, guys, so there you have it. That is the vlog. A big shout out to Activision and Infinity Ward for flying me out there to be able to experience that. And I say experience that because I've experienced a lot of Call of Duty launches. I've been part of a lot of Call of Duty launches, and there's this huge debate about everybody drinks the Kool-Aid when it comes to Call of Duty. And you're absolutely right. Everybody drinks the Kool-Aid, including myself. And sometimes it's warranted and sometimes it's not. Because I think for the most part, Call of Duty fans just want it to be good. And they just want so much that they're going to get hyped about anything. So with that being said, let's talk about Call of Duty Modern Warfare and the reasons that I'm excited for it. Now, I know we still have a ton of information to go. We don't have anything on multiplayer yet. All we have is the single player, the campaign, the offering that they gave us here for the teaser. But we can pull a ton from that. If you're a fan of old school Modern Warfare type shooters, you are going to probably enjoy this game. And I know there's people that say, even if you're living the nostalgia hype train, you can't go back to those days. And you're right. We can't go back to the days of Xbox 360 and Modern Warfare 2 lobbies and things like that, but we can get something that is pretty close. And that is what you have here, guys. Keywords for me here are tactical. Tactical, tactical, tactical. This is going to be a much more tactical Modern Warfare game. It is. I mean, from pieing around the corner, whatever you want to call it, peeking, to opening doors, I mean, things like that, cracking doors or just going in, being able to jump on anything, it is going to me, the first thing I thought when I saw this was Call of Duty meets Rainbow Six Siege. That's the first thing I thought. Now, Rainbow Six Siege is on the opposite side of the spectrum, super tactical game. A lot of people love it for that aspect. Call of Duty has always been known as an arcade-type shooter, fast-paced. What if you kind of met in the middle and you created something? And that is what I feel that we're getting with Call of Duty Modern Warfare. This is a dark, dark game, guys. They are tiptoeing the line in a lot of ways when it comes to the plot, the storyline, what you are going to see when it comes to the campaign of this game. It is a dark story they are telling. So the one thing everybody wants to know, is this a connection to the Modern Warfare trilogy? And the answer is yes and no. No, in it's not Modern Warfare 4. It's not a continuation of the Modern Warfare trilogy. It's not a prequel. It's nothing like that. It is set in the Modern Warfare universe, but it is a clean slate. So it is a reimagined, rebooted, whatever you want to call it. We'll go with reimagined Modern Warfare series. So think of God of War, the original ones, and then think about what PlayStation did with the new God of War reboot. That is exactly what you are seeing here. And to me, that's the best way to go. That's even better than Modern Warfare 4, because Modern Warfare 4 would have put restrictions on what you could actually do. You can't really bring back dead people, things like that. This one, it's fair game. It's all brand new. The sky's the limit. The story writing can go wherever they want. We could have Price. We could have Ghost. We could have Soap. We could have Makarov. We could have Shepard. We can have literally whatever they want us to have. And I think that is the perfect way to go about this. So, dark, tactical, breathtaking. This is by far the most detailed, beautiful game I've seen. And I'm not just saying that. I'm telling you that because they showed us how they actually did it this time. And I don't remember the word, but it has something to do with photography, where they take like 80 cameras and they go out and they actually capture everything in real life, and then they transport it into the video game. So you're not seeing an artist, let's say there's a couch on the ground outside and a guy dead by it. You're not seeing an artist that drew this up or created it or animated it. You are seeing actual objects. The couch was real. The dead guy was, he was real. He was an actor laying down there, and they took photographs, tons of photographs, and they imported this in to the game, which gives it the most realistic simulation feel of a Call of Duty game that I've ever seen in my life. And I'm not saying that to overhype you. You'll see what I'm talking about. You've already seen what I'm talking about. This game is the realest, authentic, most authentic looking Call of Duty to date. So, you guys saw the trailer. You saw the reveal. I want to know what you guys think. I'm going to answer all the questions I can on Twitter and in the comment section that I can. I mean, there's stuff that I can't answer, but I will do my best. But what I want to leave you guys with is super realistic, still Call of Duty feel, especially OG Call of Duty feel, okay? If you were a fan of Modern Warfare, the early Black Ops series, or anything like that, you are probably going to enjoy this. Super, super tactical. Way more tactical than any Call of Duty we've ever seen to this point. And the fact that we got to meet some of the Infinity Ward OGs that are now back with Infinity Ward after their time with Respawn, the ones that worked on COD 2, COD 3, COD Modern Warfare, Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, they're back. Griggs is back. He's actually, I think, an animator, lead animator, or something like that. I could be wrong, but we got to meet him. And it just feels right. So I know Call of Duty World War II, boots on the ground. Woo, everybody was hyped. This is a different feeling. This is boots on the ground, but this is Modern Warfare. You guys, let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I will keep you updated as we go along. Once again, Call of Duty is back on the channel, guys, full force. So I will have you guys updated. Make sure you follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you soon.